Good morning, students. Today I am continuing with the chapter number 11, and the name of the chapter is Peripheral Area. So as you see here, I am continuing with the part 3rd of this chapter, and in this video I will tell about the circle and its related some questions. So what is the meaning of circle? As you see these two figures, and as you see in this figure, there are some circular ends are there. So how can we calculate the length of these type of figures? So sometimes we face difficulty here because these are not in a straight line. So how can we identify their length, or you can say perimeter or circumferences? So first we will go with this word, that is circumferences. Circumferences is also known as a perimeter. So in my previous video I told about the perimeter, about the 2D shapes, that is rectangle, squares, okay, and then I told about the triangles and parallelogram also in my first and second video. But in this video we will focus only on circle, and then we will do some question related with these figures. So how can we will calculate the length of these figures? So before starting anything, first we have to focus on this word circumferences and perimeters of these type of figure. How can we will identify? So basically, what is circumferences? What is the perimeter of these type of figures or circle? So basically, it is a distance around a circular region. If we want to calculate the perimeter or circumferences of this type of figure, we will go with this definition. What we will say? We can say the distance around a circular region is known as a perimeter or circumferences. So if I am saying C for circumferences, basically the circumferences, if we divide by the diameter, then it becomes radius. So basically in this figure, this is radius, and the whole portion from A to B, we can say O to B, this is equivalent to R, this is equivalent to radius. And what is AB? AB is the sum of OA plus OB. So we can say OE is also equivalent to radius, and OB is also equivalent to radius, so that it becomes 2R, and this AB is known as diameter. So small d is the symbol of diameter, and small r is the symbol of radius. So if we divide the circumferences by diameter, it becomes radius. Or we can say circumferences is r into d. If we multiply the radius with diameter, it becomes the c upon d. Basically this is your pi, not r, this is pi. So if we multiply pi with d, so what it becomes? C equals to pi, and d is 2r, so we can say basically this is the circumference of a circle. C upon d equals to pi, and what is pi? Pi is constant. Pi is constant, and the value of pi is 3.14. It is standard. Right? It is constant value, and it is standard also. So the ratio of C upon D is equal to pi. So that C equals to pi into D, and what is D? D is the diameter. As I mentioned here, AB equals to D, and the value of D is 2 times of radius. 2 times of radius. So we can say C equals to 2 pi r. And the ratio of circumferences and diameter is equal to pi. Right? So we can say circumferences of a circle is more than 3 times. If the value of pi is 3.14, then we can say circumferences of a circle is more than 3 times of its diameter. This diameter. Or from here you can say circumferences of a circle is more than 3 times of its diameter. So this is the concept which is related with circumferences or perimeter of a circle. C upon D equals to pi, and pi is constant. The value of this constant is 3.14. It is the approximate value, and we can say C equals to 2 pi r. So So with the help of C equals to 2 pi r, we will calculate the length or perimeter of any type of circular shape. Okay. After this circumference is, now we will come to the next part. How can we calculate the area of a circle? The next point is area of circle. So this is the diagram of a circle, right? And this is the center basically. So if we divide, this is the half of the circle. So if we divide a circle in different types of sectors, it look like this, right? There are so many sectors we can say. So if we divide this circle in 64 sectors, right? These are different sectors, and in arrange in such a way, it look like a parallelogram, right? Just this like. If we arrange these sectors, so this look like this. So in these conditions, we will say, we will shape this circle from circular shape to parallelogram shape. So this is the shape of a rectangle. We arrange these whole 64 sectors in a shape of a parallelogram, in a shape of a rectangle. Then this AB is related with circumferences, right? And BC is related with radius. So in this case we can say this is our length and this is our breadth. So what is the meaning of area of circle in this case? We can say area of circle is equivalent to area of rectangle, because we arrange these 64 sectors of a circle in a form of a parallelogram, and that parallelogram is related with rectangle. And area of rectangle is what? Length into breadth. Then we can say here length is half of circumference of the circle, and base is equivalent to radius as per this diagram. So 2 and 2 cancel, and we will get pi r square. So this is the concept related with area of circle. So with the help of area of circle and the previous concept which is related with the circumference of circle, we will do the question very easily, which is related with exercise 12.3. Now with the help of these two concepts, perimeter of circle, or you can say circumference of circle and area of circle, we will continue with some question related with our exercise 12.3. So here r is radius and pi is constant. The value of pi is 3.14, which is a standard value, right? And capital C is the symbol of circumference of circle, which is equivalent to 2 pi r. And circumference or perimeter or length, all are same thing. Now I am taking one or two questions related with exercise 12.3. So I am taking first question from NCERT book, and I am taking the A part of this question number first, in which it is given the value of pi is 22/7. So pi is what? Pi is the ratio of C and D. So find the circumferences of the circles with the given radius, and this time it is given, radius is represented by r, that is 14 cm. Then how can we will calculate circumference of circle? So in that case we can say circumference of circle, this is equal to 2 pi r. So what we will do, we will put the value of pi, that is 22/7, and the value of r is 14 cm, and when we will solve it, what we will get? 7 cancels 14, 2 times, 2 into 22 it becomes 44, 44 into 2 it becomes 88 cm. So this is the way of calculating the value of circumferences of
circle.
So this is the A part of question number first of exercise 12.3. Now I am continuing with the next question. So after circumferences of circle, I am continuing with the question number second, and this time I am doing the B part of this question. Question number second, B part. Again, it is given to us. The value of pi is 22 upon 7. Pi is a constant quantity. It is the ratio of C and D, where C is circumference and D is the diameter. And this time, diameter is 49 meter. So how can we calculate area of circle? So basically, what is area of circle? This is equals to pi r square, right? We will put the value, that is 22 upon 7, and the value of r is, now we have to calculate r and we have to give one diameter. So what is diameter? Diameter is double of radius. So with the help of this concept, we can say diameter is 49 meter equals to 2 into radius. So we can say diameter is 49 upon 2 meter, that is, okay, we will not convert in decimal, we will put directly here. So the value of r is 49 upon 2 meter. So we will write 49 upon 2 meter, and it is in whole square. So it means 22 upon 7 into 49 meter upon 2, yeah, 49 upon 2 meter, both the same thing. Now we will go with cancellation, it will cut 11 times, and this will cut 7 times. So what we will do? We will do 11 into 7, 77, and 77 multiplied by 49. So what it becomes? It becomes 9763. 6 is remaining. This is 69. 2 is remaining. So it becomes 3773. So what we will get? We will get 3773 meter square divided by 2. Now we will divide by 2. So how can we will do? It is 1 time. Then we will do 8 times. Again we will do 8 times. This is 6. At last we will take the decimal. And then 5 times. So it means when we will solve it, we will get 1886.5 meters square. So this is the area of circle. So this is the way when the value of pi is given to us. Sometimes the value of pi is not given. On that time we will use either 22 upon 7 or 3.14 as per our convenience. But it is better for always for calculation purpose go with 22 upon 7. And diameter is given 49 meter. So with the help of given diameter we will easily calculate the value of radius. After that we will apply the formula of area of circle and put the values. So with the help of these two questions, we will do easily find the value of area of circle and circumference of circle. Now I am continuing with the some basic application related with perimeter and area. So before starting some application, please put attention on this shape. So basically this is a shape of a square. This is ABCD. ABCD is a square, and if we are saying that the side is 100 meter, it means AB is 100 meter. So definitely all the sides are equal. All the sides are equal to 100 meter. So in that case, what we will do? If we say, if I am saying that 100 meter multiplied by 100 meter, it means what? AB multiplied by BC. So what is this? This is the area of a square. Area of square ABCD. So it becomes 10,000 meter square, and the value of 10,000 meter square, this is equals to 1 hectare. Right. So with the help of this concept, you will easily solve the value of 1 hectare, that is 100 meter into 100 meter, related with the square. Okay, now we will continue with some application. And this is the last topic related with this chapter. Some application means what? So the meaning of this concept is that if, for example, one rectangle is given to you, right? This is A, B, C, B. This is a rectangle. Okay. We can say it is a rectangle. And if we construct a boundary around it, which is again a shape of a rectangle, then this is PQRS. So we can say ABCD is a inner rectangle and PQRS is a outer rectangle. Then what about this portion? Or how can we calculate this portion? Right. So this is the shaded portion. So or it is also known as portion. It is also known as, you can say, part. So how can we calculate the area of this part? So basically, how can we calculate the area of part? That is, we can say larger portion minus smaller portion. It means area of PQRS minus area of ABCD. If we do this, so definitely we will get area of path, or we will get the area of shaded portion. So this is included in this topic, that is some application. And rectangle area, we know very well, that is length into breadth. So if we know the dimensions, so definitely we will solve this type of question related with the shaded region or shaded portion. So I am doing one question related with this, so that this concept is more clear to all of you. So very interesting questions are given in exercise 12.4 related with this concept. So out of these questions, I am taking one example related with this. And this time I am doing one example, the example number 20. Okay. Example number 20 I am doing, which is related with some application. So how can we do this? This is a rectangle, right? Then outer rectangle. Okay. And the question is, example number 20 is, a rectangular part is 45 meter long and 30 meter wide. So it means this is A, B, C, D. The length is 45 meter and the breadth is 30 meter. Right? So in this example number 20, on page number 225, it is given a rectangular path is 45 meter long and 30 meter wide. A path 2.5 meter wide is constructed outside the path. Path means this is 2.5 meter. All the dimensions, these dimensions are related with 2.5 meter. Then what about PQRS? Right. So these are the dimension which is given the question. A path 2.5 meter wide is constructed outside the path. Find the area of the path. It means we have to calculate this shaded portion. This is equivalent to path. So we have to calculate the area of this path. Right. So how can we start? How can we give the answer? It is given to us AB equals to 45 meter and you can say BC is equivalent to 30 meter. These are given to us. So what about PQ? So we can say PQ, this is equivalent to 2.5 meter plus 45 meter plus 2.5 meter, right? 2.5 meter from this side. D to C it is 45 meter because in rectangle opposite sides are equal, and 2.5 meter from that side, so it becomes 50 meter. Then what about QR? And QR for this is 2.5 meter, this is 30 meter, and this is also 2.5 meter. So we can say it becomes 2.5 meter plus 30 meter plus 2.5 meter. It becomes 35 meter. It means the dimension of PCU is 50 meter and the dimension of QR is 35 meter. Now we know all the dimensions. So with the help of these dimensions, we will easily calculate the value of area of path. So after this, we will write here area of path or area of shaded portion. This is equivalent to bigger portion minus smaller portion, or we can say area of PQRS minus area of ABCD, and these are in rectangle shape. So we can say area of PQRS is PQ into QR, okay, and area of ABCD is AB into BC. Now we will put all the dimensions. So what is the value of PQ? That is 50 meter into 35 meter, and AB is 45 meter into 30 meter, right? So we will solve it. So 50 into 35, it becomes 0, 5, remaining 2, 17 meter square. This is the area of PQRS. And 45 into 30, 0, 5, remaining 1, 12, 13 meter square. And when we will solve it, we will get 400 meter square. So this is the area of path, right? So this is the area of shaded portion. So I hope with the help of these questions, you will solve the remaining questions which are related with this exercise or this exercise, that is exercise 13.3 and 13.4. So go with the concept and go through with the examples also, so that you will do the question related with some applications and circumferences of circles and area of circles. Thank you very much.